This video is all about UFC Fight Night Rozenstruik vs Sakai, which is happening this weekend. If you are a new UFC fan who doesn't have time to watch the full card but also doesn't wanna miss any important fight, so here I will tell you which fight you shouldn't miss this weekend and why. Hello everyone and welcome to the UFC book. Let's start the video with the headlining bout Jairzinho Rozenstruik vs Augusto Sakai. Jairzinho Rozenstruik holds the record of 11 wins and 2 losses and is on number 6 ranked in heavyweight rankings. Rozenstruik is a former kickboxer with a pretty good record of 76 wins and 8 losses. He joined UFC in 2019 as an undefeated mixed martial artist with a record of 6-0 and successfully won his debut via TKO. He defeated Alan Crowder in 9 seconds and then former heavyweight champion Andrei Arlovski in just 29 seconds to get his first 5-round main event against Alistair Overeem. He knocked out Overeem in the last seconds of the 5th round, which was one of the most brutal knockouts in UFC history, and challenged Francis Ngannou to get a title shot against then heavyweight champion Stipe Miocic. You can call it his bad luck or Ngannou's skills, but his call out to Ngannou proved to be the biggest mistake of his career. He got knocked out cold by the heavy punches of Ngannou in just 20 seconds. Following his first and devastating loss, he TKO'd Junior Dos Santos, and then in his last fight against Cyril Gane, he lost the second time in UFC, this time with a unanimous decision after 5 boring rounds. His opponent Augusto Sakai got the UFC contract by defeating his opponent in Dana White's Contender Series back in 2018 and went 4-0 in UFC. He lost his first UFC fight in his last match against Alistair Overeem via TKO in the 5th round, which was his first 5 rounds main event, and now is ranked as number 9 with his MMA record of 15 wins and 2 losses. Both fighters lost their last fight but are motivated to get back in the winning column. One of them will come back on the winning side to maintain his position in the heavyweight division, and one is going to be replaced by some other heavyweight contender. Talking about the co-main event, it is also a heavyweight bout between number 8 ranked Walt Harris and number 11 ranked Marcin Tybura. Harris holds the record of 13 wins and 9 losses. He has been a part of UFC since 2003 and fought 16 times in the octagon. His UFC record is 7 wins and 8 losses. I don't want to provide wrong info about fighters, so being honest, I don't understand how he is in the top 10 with that bad record. Although no one gives a damn about my opinion, I think he is gonna get out of the top 10 list because his opponent Marcin Tybura is really a rising star and is on a 4 fight win streak. Marcin Tybura joined the UFC in 2016 with the record of 13 wins and only 1 loss. One of his wins is over former heavyweight champion Andrei Arlovski, and he defeated Greg Hardy in his last match back in December 2020. Now he holds the MMA record of 21 wins and 6 losses. These two fights are very important for the heavyweight division of UFC, so you must not miss them. Any of them can be seen in the top 5 in the near future if he shows impressive performance. One more fight that you might find interesting is a welterweight bout where undefeated Miguel Baeza with the record of 10-0 will try to improve his record against Santiago Ponzinibbio, whose MMA record is 27 wins and 4 losses. Baeza has only 3 fights in UFC and he earned performance of the night bonus in his last 2 fights. Whereas his opponent Santiago Ponzinibbio made his UFC debut in 2013, where he couldn't impress the fans at the start of his career and was 2-2 in his first 4 UFC fights. But after his second UFC loss back in June 2015, he kept winning and improving his skills. He defeated Mike Perry in his 6th straight win and KO'd number 8 ranked Neil Magny in a spectacular way to earn a performance of the night bonus in his 7th straight victory. In the next fight, his opponent pulled out due to COVID-19, so number 11 ranked Li Jingliang stepped in as a replacement on short notice. Ponzinibbio couldn't keep his streak unbroken and lost the fight by a first round knockout. Now that his streak is broken, he is coming back to break the 10 fights win streak of Miguel Baeza. It would definitely be interesting to see how Baeza defends his undefeated record. 3 other fights of the card are of middleweight division. All fighters are unranked, and if any fighter gives an impressive performance, he can have a chance to make his name in the top 15. So now don't miss these 3 fights, but if you like watching UFC and have plenty of free time, you can watch all 6 fights of the card. And if you have nothing to do and you can sacrifice your 6 hours of sleep for UFC, there are 8 more fights in its preliminary card. You can watch them as well, because it is the most violent sport in the world for a reason. Anything can happen in the blink of an eye. I hope you will get some wow moments in it. In India, prelims will start at 1:30 a.m. and the main card will start at 4:30 a.m. this Sunday. Both will start 30 minutes prior in Pakistan and 30 minutes after in Bangladesh. Which country are you from? Tell me in the comments if you want the details according to your country. Like the video if you enjoyed any part of it and subscribe and turn on the notification to watch more videos. We will meet in the next video, so till then, do whatever you want.